This is one array, and we have given some list of values here. Then in this array, I want to search for a particular value 12. Whenever I get a value 12, I want to immediately come out from that. This is all some extra programming. I'm creating array with integer I equal to 0, I less than something. Say for example, here if I just do it normally, if I take this program outside, I want to display what are the values we have in an array. I can do it in a simple way. This is a statement comment, starting from the for loop. When you create array, this will give an example of how we can use arrays and to display the values. Now this is the array actually, and this is the array name. Means array contains multiple values, means more than one value. So I want to display what is the value we have. Let's say for example, how many values we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We have 10 values total. So means maximum, since always array starts from the position 0, so even in case you want to get what is the maximum length of array, so you can see like array, what it is doing, it is taking starting from the 0, and then it is trying to get the length of the array, array name dot length. So this will get the length of array. And so now what I am doing here, every time whenever I am reading it, and I just want to read what is the value we have in that position. So it loop will zero, start from 0, go up to length of minus 1. So now since it is a 9, total length is 10, so it will go for minus 1, that is up to 9. It will continue from 0 to 9, and this will be continuously running. So in this case, I am just taking out all this outside. So in this case, we are just writing a simple loop actually. This is a very basic loop. Okay, in case you are confused, you can take out everything also here. Okay, so this no commands we have, only the loop. For loop is starting from here. And we are just writing whatever value your for loop will be reading. So this is your array is defined. Array means list of values we already know. And we are starting from 0, and then less than of this, it is going to run it. it is starting from, okay, starting value, even in case you want to make it bit proper. So zero, at zero position we have a 32 value, at one position we have this number like this, up to 0 to 9. So loop started from 0 and ending at a 9, so to total 10 position. So this is the starting value and then this is the ending value. So like this we can write the loop to get the benefit from here. So one of the simple examples. So when your loop is running, it will, once it starts it will continue forever, but in case you want to give a break. Say for example, right now it is reading all, but what I want to do, whenever I am searching a value, let's say for example, if at all, the array value, array of this 0, 1, 2, 3, it keep reading the values. In case, if this value is equivalent to whatever value I am going to search. So search for is a data type here given as a 12. So whenever your array value, if it becomes 12, so I want to immediately break it. So this is, I'm keeping a keyword like found it equal to 2, so you may use or you may not use it, okay? So immediately I'm just making it to come out from the break, and then it will keep a flag, okay, true into this data type, because it is a Boolean data type we have defined over here, so it will define a value true here. Based on that, okay, whether to just to check out whether this has become true or not, at least whether you have a value in that or not. So we are keeping that, and then we are writing another condition, like if this value is true, okay, then we found the search value, okay, otherwise it will say that we couldn't find it, okay. So this will continue for all, but whenever this get matches with the 12, then immediately it is going to come out from that is called break, okay. So you can, even the break statement can be written for while and do while also, in case if it is necessary or if you want to use it. So break always terminates your loop, that's all, simple. Okay, so now it is displaying all the values. You see that, okay, value of 0 is 32, value of 1 is 82, but as soon as it reaches 4th position is 12, so it terminated, the equivalent progress to the next level, it is terminated, okay, and then immediately it will take you to the outside and then it is displaying this message, whatever you have written inside, outside. So it is not continuing the loop, that is a break. Earlier it was displaying all the arrays, but right now it is, as soon as we get the value 12, because we are searching it, then immediately it is taking out. And when you come out from the loop, so these are the programs written here. So found out equal to true means I'm taking whether this value is true or not. So since it is true, then it is going to display here. So this way, breaks can be used over here. I'm just writing a loop. So even in the one loop, we can also write nested loops. Let's say, for example, I have a loop. Okay. So even I can also write nested loops. So whenever you are writing a nested loop, so to indicate from which loop you are coming out. Say for example, this is one loop and within that I have one more loop, which is J. So I am writing is J loop here, starting from here to here. So when you say break, okay, if you just say normal break, and it will come out from this particular loop, and then it will continue the parent loop. So whenever you say like break cycle, let's say if you see here, this is just a particular name we are giving. So this named break, what it does, you can have a, it will particularly come out from this particular, if you see search, we are starting, okay, a keyword from here, and whenever you say break, normally it will come out and then simply continue your program. But whenever you say break search, okay, it is going to break complete from this particular IP. So wherever search is there, till the time where search you see, the complete program block is going to be come out from here. So not only the for loop. When you say normal break, it will completely come out from the entire program. But when you say break a search, particular break, so your search program starts from here, it will completely come out because search is actually even main for loop also under search, so that it will completely come out from out. Completely comes out from that, then it will continue, okay, where you are and that all position. Otherwise, if you say normal break, and this break generally take you completely from outside, okay, and completely from outside from the this one, and then but the parent loop will be continued. But since you are breaking to this position, so it is completely jumping out to this one, and then this will be continued here. So this is just something called labeled break, okay. And in the same way, continue also there, okay. What continue? Say for example, break is completely taking out, but whenever there is some activity matches, so then I want to continue. Okay, say for example, in this example, I have some, this is also a very basic example. I'm just to have some a simple text value here, and then I'm trying to display the values character by character which we have here. So what I'm trying to do, if search me is at check and caret position I, okay, if not equal to p, continue, okay. So otherwise you do the plus. If you say p, then it will say continue means it will continue. Otherwise only it is going to say increment and then going to continue. If it is not equal to p, only continue, okay. Otherwise it will just comes out from here. Say for example, now you see it is directly doing only 9, okay, position P in this thing. So it is not doing all the continuous this thing. It is just simply taking. So this is the character value we have here, and then maximum is what is the maximum length of this particular. So there is some big number is here. Okay, that is the length it is taking. And what it is doing, we are creating a loop, integer I equal to 0, okay, I is less than max, because we need to find out what is the maximum length, and then I plus this. So if, what it is doing, if search me, at, in a normal case, if I keep just a command here, so it will keep continuing, but what I am doing here, if not equal to p, okay, the whatever value is there, if it is not equal to p, okay, then I'm saying continue means it just continue, don't do any activity. I'm not going to display anything here. And then continue means increment it and then just continue here. I'm not going to do anything here. But in case if you don't say continue, okay, it will expect some numbers and it will expect something, and then whatever you do, it will display. But right now what we are saying is in case, okay, if your value is not, let's say what it is doing, if you see, loop is there, but I'm not writing any program, so I have a position column 0 here. So whenever this value is not equal to P, okay, then it is going to increment it by 111. And in case it is not equal to, it is not going to do anything. So it will not come to this position in case this value is equal to P. Otherwise, it is going to continue. So how many number of total P's we have? Okay, total 9 P's we have. The P characters we have 9. How can I come to know that? Say maybe these kind of things again you may sometimes have to use in MapReduce also. Okay, some kind of algorithms they are like. It is starting from here. Okay, so anyway it starts from the zero position. Okay, in a normal case it will keep giving every value. Okay, but since it is starting from the P here, okay, so it will come to here. So it will try to compare. Okay, this is not equal to P. Okay, since it is not equal to P, it is not even taking to the outside. If you say break, the loop will completely come outside, then it will start continue. But when you say continue, since this value is not equal to P, then it says that continue. Continue means don't go to the next bottom position, immediately you go here, so don't do any activity here. And again it will go to the second E, oh, sorry, first case it is P, it is a matching, so then it will come to here. Okay, then it will increment by 1 because you got a P. Second character E not equal to P, continue, don't increment this number, right? And like this it will continue. Whenever you get a P again, okay, then it will go here. If it is not equal to P, it is continue. So this way we are going to count how many number of P's we have in particular character here or particular string here. So if you don't say continue, it will keep. Say for example, I'll just comment this if condition here, just for example. So this we already know that since we are talking about I equal to 0, I less than of maximum length. Maximum means this is the total length of this one. Okay? And then it will continue. Every time it is 0 is there, it is incrementing by 1. So we'll come to know total how many number of characters we have. So total 44 characters we have in this because it is going to continue your program continuously from here to here. But now what we are doing, if at all my character is, okay, whatever character I at this position, first to second, third position, because char at means we already know whatever index number you give, at particular number what is the character we have. So in case this value not equal to P, then don't do any increment because it is, I am looking for P only, so don't increment it. It says that continue. So continue means again it will go here. In case if this value equal to P, okay, then increment it. Okay, so anyway that statement is there. So that's why it is not going to do whatever activities we have kept in the loop for every time, and only some condition is satisfied, then only it is doing, otherwise it is going. So now you can see 9 times the P is present over here. The rest we will see tomorrow.